Hello children, in this video we will learn what is the meaning of symmetry. Come, let's see what Sher Khan is doing. But what is this? He has just drawn half portion of the sun and there is no more space left in the paper. What do I do now? Sher Khan said sadly. Just then, he looked into the mirror lying just next to him. Magic! Magic! Sher Khan was excited. This mirror is magical. It has completed my drawing, Sher Khan thought. The very next day, he called some of his friends to see the magical mirror at his home with half-done images. Which image have you bought, Golu Panda? Sher Khan asked this to Golu Panda. I have drawn a half portion of a toffee. I felt that your mirror is magical, so when it completes my image, then I will eat it, Golu Panda said, drooling. My magical mirror will definitely complete your image, but you will not be able to eat the toffee. Understood, Fatso? Sher Khan said to Golu. Abracadabra. Now see how this image becomes complete in my magical mirror. Sher Khan said this and placed Golu's painting in front of the mirror. Wow! All the friends were shocked to see how the second part of the image is visible in the mirror. Come Appu, I will show magic with your painting. Sher Khan repeated the magical words and second part of Appu's painting is also visible in the mirror. Appu and Golu started clapping excitedly, but Bhola Donkey was quiet. Come Bhola, now it's the turn of your cup painting, said Sher Khan to Bhola and tried to take his painting, but Bhola refused. This is enough magic for one day, my friend. We will see magic with this painting later on, Bhola said to Sher Khan. Appu and Golu went home. Sher Khan asked Bhola why he did not allow him to show the magic with his painting. Because your magic will fail. You can't try it right now, Bhola said to Sher Khan and handed over the painting of his half cup to him. Sher Khan placed Bhola's painting in front of the mirror. But what is this? The second half of the cup in the mirror doesn't seem to appear. Sher Khan was surprised and asked Bhola, how did you come to know that my magic is going to fail? That is because my painting was not a symmetrical object, Bhola said to Sher Khan. Bhola started scratching his head and asked, what is a symmetry? Symmetry happens when two parts of any object are the same. This is the reason when you see one half of an object in the mirror, then you can see the other half looking exactly the same, and you feel that the picture is complete. There is no magic in your mirror. Magic actually is in symmetry. Yes. But what about the secret of my magic mirror? Sher Khan said sadly. Don't worry, your secret is safe with me. Then Bhola winked at Sher Khan and they both began to laugh. So children, in this lesson, we learnt what is meant by symmetry. In the next video, we will learn more about this with some examples. Of symmetry. In the previous video, we learned what is symmetry. Do you remember Sher Khan's magical mirror? Can you identify which of these incomplete images will become a complete image in the mirror? Good, you got it right. These are the images that will be complete in the mirror because they are made of two similar parts. And these images will not be complete in the mirror because they are not made of two similar parts. In this video, we will learn to divide an image into two similar parts with the help of dotted lines. Shere Khan became very popular because of his magical mirror. But one day, he noticed that there's a huge crowd around Meenu in the classroom. "Look, I will draw a dotted line on the image and it will divide the image into similar parts." Meenu is telling children with the image of a star in her hand. She draws a line like this on the image. Wow, this magic is better than Shere Khan's magical mirror. The children shout with excitement. Shere Khan draws a C on a paper and shouts, "If your magic is better than my magic, then can you divide this C in two similar parts with the help of a dotted line?" Meenu smiled and drew a dotted line like this on Shere Khan's C. Shere Khan is shocked. He takes Bhola to one corner of the classroom and tells him, "Bhola, you are very clever. Can you teach Meenu a lesson by proving that her magic is a failure?" "Okay, I'll help you," Bhola said to Shere Khan. Bhola draws a socks on the paper and tells Meenu, "Can you divide this image into two similar parts by using a dotted line?" Meenu thinks a lot and says, "No, I can't." Shere Khan starts laughing, looking at her, and other children feel surprised that her magic has failed. Then Bhola explains, "There is no magic. There are some alphabets and objects that are made of two similar parts. Therefore, they can be divided into two similar parts by using a dotted line. However, there are some objects and letters that are not made of two similar parts. Therefore, they cannot be divided into two similar parts by using a dotted line. Children, can you guess which among these images can be divided into two similar parts by a dotted line?" "Wow, you are smart. These are images that are being divided into two similar parts by the dotted lines. And these are not getting divided into two similar parts." Appu gets excited. "Bhola, I have made a mask of my face on this sheet and I have also drawn this line. Can you tell me how will I come to know if this line is dividing my mask into two similar parts or not?" "This is very easy. If you want to know whether a dotted line can divide an image into two similar parts or not, then just fold the image along with the dotted line. If both parts coincide, then the line is dividing the image into two similar parts. This is the reason your line is not dividing your mask into two similar parts," Bhola said to Appu. All the children are impressed by Bhola's intelligence and promise not to call him a donkey ever again. "Come children, today I will teach you one more interesting fact. Can you tell me what are the difference between these two images of Babban?" "Yes, this is correct. Whatever you are seeing in the left image is completely opposite to the image on the right. For instance, his left hand is on his waist in the left image, but in the right image, his right hand is on the waist. In fact, If you see the image of the left hand in front of the mirror, then you can see the image on the right hand in the mirror. Such images that are similar but completely opposite of each other are called mirror images. Here are some examples of mirror images. Now try to see different objects in the mirror and enjoy learning more about them. In this video, we learned about mirror images and dividing images into two equal parts with the help of dotted lines.